Yes, we are. All right, I call the Lyon County Fiscal Court Special Call Meeting to order, July 25th, 2022, 1:00 invitation.
Good morning, happy, just thankful for that day. Community we live in, really thankful for people that have run the community, that have support to the community, thank you for our first responders. They would think much of the family. Pray for our country, pray for all the citizens of our neighborhood, from the federal level, the national level, that guides we see from here, as well as we do here at the local level and at the state level. We pray for about the time we have here today, businesses transacted, that we get the price like that, and give you our value for that stuff.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
No visitor comments. All right, Patrick, bring the flip to pavement. We just got the document signed on the 80-20 culvert plan for the same road. All that's done, the culverts are ordered. Now we've got the flex paving, which the road to pave is about 176, and the flex funds is 166. So we got a few thousand of after all paid for the flex. So this is the agreement, the resolution. So I need a motion on that. Motion by Jeff, second by Bobby. Any discussion on that?
Just one more word.
All of it, yeah, all of it. We gotta get all those culverts in. I think this has got the largest set of culverts of any road that I can think of. We're replacing
seven to nine,
somewhere in there, and there's three or four more that they're in good shape. So, all right, all those in favor say aye. Those nay. I think that passes. 911 increase. Danny, just go ahead and start.
This is from the KSP dispatching service calls from the letter that was dated on June 29th that Judge White received. I'm also, hopefully he doesn't mind, have Sheriff White help as the commander of KSP at one time and some, if there's questions. So until 2015, the cost that Lyon County was paying for dispatching services was $31,264. And that's according to the documentation that Krista provided, which I believe all of you have a copy as well. Then in 2015, it increased to $46,207.16. That was a 45% increase from the previous amount. And then again in 2016, it went up to $50,827.84, and that's what we're currently paying at the moment. However, the proposed increase to start January of 2023 is $134,754.84. That is a 265% increase from what we're currently paying. So the current contract, we pay $50,827 for one telecommunicator and one console. According to the contract, it does not break down the cost of where that $50,827 is going. The new contract, again, is $134,754.84. According to KSP, that's one telecommunicator and one console. a difference of $83,927. Again, it's a 265% increase. And I do have the breakdown on that according to what KSP sent. So their breakdown is an entry-level telecommunicator is $76,569.80. That is the salary in the fringe for an entry-level telecommunicator.
It's a two, right?
It's a telecommunicator two.
Entry-level is one.
Entry-level is one.
They probably put it in contract for a two, because it can be anywhere from one to three.
Okay. Then they added 911 support and personnel. This is what they're calling the administrative charge. $29,149.80, and this is supposed to be for GIS, 911, telephoning, business administration, the medical director that provides the emergency medical dispatch rent. And according to Jimmy Kitchens from the Kentucky State Police, he included, this is a portion Lyon County pays, all agencies split this total. I do know Judge White sent him back. Well, what agencies are splitting this? The equipment license support and maintenance, which is the CAD, I believe the COT's Commonwealth Office of Technology, that I think KSP now owns. There's no more COT.
State police used to have their own IT people, and the governor, a couple governors ago, made every state agency go to the Commonwealth Office of Technology. They don't own the Commonwealth Office of Technology. So they have to pay for every plug-in that plugs in for data or phone, mainly data, excuse me, phone's kind of weird, but data. So if you have one of those ports in your wall, every one of them cost, they have to pay a fee to COT. Every computer that plugs up to that's a separate cost, and I think that's what we're talking about there.
Then you have the tire phone fees and furniture. This is what they're calling the infrastructure charge on that breakdown sheet of $6,900. Then they're looking at telephoning, the Solacom terminal, and a 5-year prorated refresh with all combined ALI selective routing and jointly provided systems. It's $14,680. Sheriff, you know exactly what that is.
Yeah, so what they're talking about there, any alley is the, when the phone comes up, if you use this phone right here, it's going to come up on any, or excuse me, alley. It's the automated locating index feature on your phone. So if your GPS services are on, when you call 911, if it's an AT&T phone, it's going to be within 3 feet, it's going to ping within 3 foot of where you actually are. If you're a Verizon phone, it can be 1,200 feet of where you're on. But that's a cost that the telephone company charges for the 911 trunk to be able to have that feature. Solacom is the vendor for some of those services.
And then you have the radio resource network charge. We actually have two. We have our main channel and the TAC channel. That's why we're getting charged twice at $3,700 on that. The $76,569, the telecommunicator, that is the same that had the Purchase Area Development District, which is the PSAT board. They are getting charged that exact same amount. The $29,000, they are getting charged that exact same amount. The radio of the $3,703.37, they are getting charged that exact same amount. The $6,900 and the $14,000 is different from what the purchase area, and I believe Judge White is asking, why is there a difference? He's emailed KSP to ask them, you know, they're getting $11,000, ours is $14,000. We're having $6,900 and theirs is $4,000. According to KSP, they received no legislative funding for 911, no statutory obligation to provide 911. They have no funding mechanism by statute to impose a tax fee, et cetera, for 911 services or the counties and the cities do, and they received no funding for CMRS funding. We get about $5,000 that goes to the CAD board, is that correct, Judge?
Yeah, that is from people paying $1 for a phone line. We got
got 400 acres still in the county.
So the pricing will start January 1st and April 1st because we pay in quarters. And basically in the letter that he sent, kind of like your first bill's not due till July 1, but you're going to have to pay that 6 months, that $83,000, that difference in that 6 months. The new contract will be valid from January 1 to June 30th of 2024. With possible changes again in July of 2024. So all of this information came from Jimmy Kitchens and the letter that he sent and the breakdown. I just tried to make it easier in the PowerPoint for you all to see.
So is the 83,000 increase, the 2 days of pay that will be billed January 1 and April 1, is it, since that's half of the fiscal year, is it going to be half 83 or is it going to be full 83? That's what I can't figure out.
Yeah.
They tell us it's going to start January 1, but then that current, where they say the new contract valid, or the possible, you know, that pricing will start
January 1, 23.
Yeah, but there's another somewhere, maybe on the other page.
For which one?
Pricing will start January 1, and the other one will be April 1. We pay a quarter. So we've got 1 quarter left that we're going to pay. The way I understand it, we'll be to the higher price in January. That's the way I understand it.
Yeah, the one you pay in October and the one you pay in December is on the current rate. But the way I read it, in January.
Yeah.
Yeah.
My question is, we're going to receive 74,000 in a 6 month period.
No, I think you'll divide the 134 by 4. It's already in there from the start of January. That's the way I understand it. Which, of course, is, you know, for this quarter, or for this fiscal year coming that we're in now, it's going to be an additional $41,000.
So $33,688 is what you'll pay a quarter, and right now you're only paying. You got that paper? What is it, 12?
Yeah, a little over 12.
A little over 12 a quarter.
So we got several things we got to figure out. One, we're waiting on them. We've asked, okay, we want to see this in the review that we've done. And once we get that, we'll check it again. We'll try to figure out what to do for them. The other thing I've sort of put on notice of is that I'm going to spread this over 4 years, this increase, because a 265% increase for us, 400% increase for another county I know about, and then there's some larger increases for others. That's hard to just simply deal with. And I think the responsible thing for KSP would have been is to want us in on this. Let us know, hey, we're losing a lot of money here if that's the case. And let us work towards that, not just all of a sudden, boom, here it is. When we're in the middle of a fiscal year.
I mean, we've had a good, you were probably at post. I mean, the price has been.
We've had it good for a long time, but I agree, actually. They have the same fiscal year that we do. They know that dropping this in on counties on June 30th, right before the fiscal year starts, is irresponsible. And I don't blame you for asking for the detailed analysis, because I would do the same thing if I were in you. After looking at what Jamie showed me, what I think they're trying to do is over the past years that I was associated with state police, they always tried to pay for the cost of the dispatchers, the telecommunicators. What it looks like they're trying to recoup now is all the other costs that they actually have and spread that out among the users. I'm surprised you don't see electricity in here. Electricity was obviously the biggest bill I paid as a postman, and I can't remember, it was under $20,000, but it was a lot per month to run all that equipment at these posts. But I think they're just trying to capture all those calls.
Yeah, like I said, there's one, you know, 40%.
Brown, yeah.
I think it was Brown.
Brown, I think.
Yeah. And there's four entities, correct me if I'm wrong, that pay in. You have us, Mayfield City, Graves County, and then the PSAT board.
Yeah, we got four. There used to be a lot more. It used to be Callaway and Fulton. But it's just those four main entities now that make up the board. We still have some board members, I think, from Ballard and maybe Hickman because of the way they set up the satellite. It's not very many agencies that spread all that. Do we know how much Graves and Mayfield went up?
No, I'm asking.
Nathan Kent said about $20,000. That was just for him. Yeah, because he made the comment that it was about $500,000 or a little more than that when he was the post commander, that Mayfield was paying for their own dispatch.
Yeah.
And when they came, he said, we're still not even paying half of that to KSP.
So. As bad as this sounds, it's still a good deal, but it's just a terrible way to present it to you all. I think the time is right. I think it's very reasonable to y'all think.
And post, correct me if I'm wrong, Gary Fraser said this morning that dispatch were like 29 entities. So Lyon County for us is Edible Fire, Edible PD, Lyon, so the Tall Fire, the Coroner, the Jailer, EMS, and EM.
I think they have us listed as 11 agencies because they count the rural fire districts,
okay.
And that's really
yes.
Edible cost. EMS, Edible PD, Edible Fire, Tall Fire, Lyon County Rural Fire District 1, Lyon County Rural Fire District 2, which is essentially Edible Tall. Service and Rescue, EM, Coroner, Sheriff's Office, and Jailer.
So it's another question, you know, we invite the cities in to help us pay this.
I'll tell you the way in the old way how counties and cities did things, because when I was on the county police, that's how we did it. We did it by census. We did it by percentage, by census. And that actually was a pretty fair way of doing things, I thought, back in the day. And it would change every time there was an updated census. That's an option to you. And I think, I'm not 100% sure, but I think the cities could potentially use ABC money or some ABC money for some of that. It might be an allowable expenditure.
That's another thing too. If we start changing how we're going to pay this by collecting from the cities, there's another aspect of this too, which is the $1 telephone bill. Right now, everybody that's part of this PSAP has to bring $1, at least $1 per month for landlines. And of course, that's why that number is so low. Everybody's compared to landlines. We've got about 420 people still have them. So if we started collecting from the cities, if we do away with that, are we going to have to change the PSAP agreement? Because that's one of the things it calls for is a dollar charge on that. So this is, all of this requires so many different things. It requires the cooperation from all the other cities and all the other counties that are involved in the PSAP over there. A lot of moving parts to it. It's not just, if we make some kind of a move, it affects everybody.
And that
rate's
changed, or Mayfield changed theirs. Theirs isn't a dollar on the land. Mayfield went to the $4 fee on their water bill, but their water is for profit. It is not a city or county owned, correct me if I'm wrong, entity. So they put a $4 fee on every water bill because you may have property, it may not have a building on it, but if that land gets expired, you've got to have water. And so they did a $4 flat fee, and that has covered their expense, according to Chief Nathan Kenneth, I feel he did.
I think that's just the city, right?
Yes, that's just Nathan City's.
You've got three entities, and then you've got a lot of people in the way. Does some of you get interested in water? Who's one?
Maybe I have 293, I can't remember.
Is yours one? Definitely. Of course, this was a debate we had back last time. You were here. We debated how we were going to follow what some of these other counties were doing as far as putting the extra charge on the tax bill, the property tax bill. We looked at water, we looked at electric, we looked at all those things. And there was a lot of lawsuits going on at the time trying to, some people were suing the counties. They were trying different things, and I really haven't been back to see what shook out from all that.
Just so I think everybody knows, but you might ask, well, why can't we do something with the cell phones? That's all controlled by the general assembly. The state has the jurisdiction over the carriers as it pertains to cell phones, so we can't put any tax on the cell phone. That money is already taxed or fee based, and we get a very minute amount.
Yeah, it's only like 7 cents, I think, unless they've been trying to raise it, but they've not made any traction.
I think the maximum frustration, I don't know what you're talking about, we're trying to be raising the call.
Yeah, I just need to go down. There it is. So, my plan is to get that in-depth review, and once we look through that review, I'll get it to everybody. We can decide what we're going to do next. My next thing, if it all looks normal, I'd like to see if we get this split apart, and that would increase every year for 4 years.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's another thing, you know, our 4% that we will be doing here in August, it's gone. That's what we're doing.
Jake, you want to turn this back?
You would just have to coordinate with him to see how.
Let me always stress this, the only four entities that use are us, Grady's, Mayfield, and Pat.
That's just for this post area. They do have satellite services to other places, it's just not the full service component that we have. So they dispatch, they receive the 911 call, they input it into the computer, they dispatch. And in their case, in fire department's case, they page them out, and then they keep up with all our dispatch records, and they do all of that for us. They don't page us, but they dispatch us. That's right. They do all the fire departments in Grady County, which is over 10.
There's like 13.
Yeah, maybe 13. They do Mayfield, City Mayfield. Mayfield does the EMS for the whole county. Mayfield, Grady County EMS, they do the fire department, animal control, all of them.
Let me ask you this. Dean Anderson was talking to you, you know, he said, of course, the purchase area got to be as a piece of. For theirs went from 119 to 199,000. And he said, everybody keep in mind the PSAP is paying for 911 and the counties are paying for the dispatch. What does that mean? What's he saying that? Because the PSAP isn't paying for dispatch.
Well, yeah, I don't understand. That may be in his mind where the original establishment of the purchase area development district 911 board was, maybe that was what the original intent was, how they did that. But I think today, I'd have to look at your contract, but I don't see that as being bifurcated now. That's what we're paying.
Their breakdown, the PSAP's breakdown looked a lot like that.
Yeah, I mean, I think you're paying for it all, you know. I think what has happened over the years, they've had somewhat of a failed formula, and whereas they were only capturing the personnel cost, and for example, I was explaining to Jamie. Jamie asked about the medical director. Why do you got to have a medical director? So if you call 911, Quinn, and say you need to give CPR to your daughter, that dispatcher is going to go to is going to go to a software program that costs money. It's updated constantly, and they're going to give you instructions based upon what is on that screen and based upon what you say back to them. And then five of those per month that where they dispatch an ambulance, Lyon County ambulance, that they've given EMD directions to somebody, five of those are going to pick per month. They're going to send them to electronically this medical director in Frankfurt. And he or she is going to then review that and determine if they did it right. And then they provide that feedback. So it's things like that they're trying to capture those costs. That, I mean, I'm not taking up for them. I'm just saying that's what it appears that they're trying to recoup those expenses, whereas they haven't been doing that ever before.
So y'all won't be doing anything different other than what I'm doing. I'm asking for the in-depth review, and then after I get it, I suppose that's when I'll lay out what we think we can pay over. Is this something that I think we need to vote on, or just want to think that?
Not necessarily, because you need to see whether or not KSP would be receptive to your department in long terms. You've got to get that document and come back to you.
They've done this before, and got backlash from counties previously. They've done this
before. How long ago? Before my time?
2012, 2010, somewhere around there. They did this before.
That's been 10, I don't remember.
Yeah, they've done this before and received backlash, and their timing was off. I'm pretty sure just like this, and there was little notice.
It was exactly the same according to Nathan.
Yeah. Me and Nathan dealt with this before. I was his lieutenant from 06 to 13. And it had to be within that time period. And I mean, they should know better. I mean, I don't blame you for getting all that you're asking for and your time to it, and I would want to see it through the time. I think it's unreasonable to ask for it right before the day before the fiscal year is supposed to start. Even if it is delayed 6 months, they have the same fiscal year as we do.
Yeah, and like Quinn was saying, I'm just disappointed they haven't sent me this in-depth review.
Yeah.
It's got to be on their computer.
I think.
He acted like when I called him, they were shifted to papers. That's hard to understand.
I imagine it was probably this simple. They probably took everything, all their licenses, all of the support stuff, and they started to divide it by all their users that they had contracts with.
Brent, this is probably the only option the county's got, right?
There are other options, but in my opinion, it's the best option for Lyon County. It's probably the cheapest option. There's no way, like Jamie was saying, Mayfield was paying $550,000 just to do their dispatch. I think that was with 7 people. You got to have 7 to 9 people, bricks and mortar. There's no way we can do it for that, but it's still, I think you're responsible to play this on. You might need more time to prepare. But it's, I mean, there, you can contract with other counties. It's just hard to change over, but it could be done.
Anything else? All right, Amanda.
All right.
We got the Westport Park that is the 500 acres out there by the prison farm.
Do you want me to?
Yes.
Oh.
No, you don't have to.
Oh, okay.
You don't have to.
Okay. So there is a 500 acre parcel that's owned by the Commonwealth of Kentucky, north of the prison farm. It's basically the north side of New Bethel Road. There is an IDA board made up of appointments from the judge executives of Caldwell, Crittenden, Lyon, Livingston, and Trigg counties, and the executive director of PAD. This 6-person board is the local authority over the site. I'm looking at applying for a grant, the same grant, one of the grants we got out at the annual Industrial Park, to do an engineering study to figure out why that site floods. It didn't flood in the early 2000s when we initially did all of our environmental work. In 2018, it got put in the floodplain. So we're looking to apply for a grant to do the engineering to figure out why it floods. My guess is the ice storm has something to do with it and clogged up the creek bank, and that's part of why it floods. So from you all, I need an appointment to that IDA board, or I guess Wade gets to appoint it, but I need him to make the appointment in a fiscal board meeting.
I make a motion I appoint Wade.
Okay, thank you so much. Yes, Lee. What?
He wants me to abstain.
No, the bylaws specifically says the appointment has to come from the judge executive. And it's always been the judge executive of the county that appoints himself over this board.
I don't even think I have to come to the record.
That's all. I needed the appointment to be in a record. Do you want me to show you the bylaws real quickly? I guess I should have emailed this to you.
I have studied this.
Yeah, it says that under membership. what?
It's always full.
Yeah, it did use always one?
It's always full.
Yeah, it's, see, and that's one that engineering report that I said showed that it had flooded. So that's what we wanna figure out, does it?
We want to see if it got fixed yet.
Yeah, or there's an easy fix.
We got a man there since I've been there, they all have.
It always does, always.
That's what I told her.
That's, I told them, I just wanted a record of it.
So can I just say, I'm appointing myself, clerk, please put that in minutes.
That's what I think I just needed a record of it.
Wait, why, it's now been appointed to.
Why are you executive order?
No, I mean, we can have an executive order.
Just a regular minutes.
Yeah.
I don't just think it's not like a reason. I think you can do that grant.
Yeah, I think I just needed it to happen in a meeting.
Krista or Kristy? I'm used to yelling at Krista. Please put in the records that I've appointed myself to the West Park Industrial Department. Yes. Alright, we got two claims, the cost of our post office boxes went up $6 to $4. So, we need a motion. I think we need a motion to do it. We'll just, if y'all are okay with it, we'll just name one to be paid. And anything else from the magistrates? Pursuant to KRS 61.810, section 1, subsection L, executive session for the purpose of hiring, firing, or discipline of an individual employee. Is there a second? Second by Bobby. All those in favor say aye. Opposed, nay. Hearing none, there are not executive sessions. How about that? Everybody, get out.
Okay, I'm gonna be coming as hot, of course.
All right.